Non più dovrai far felogni amoroso, notte e giorno di torno girando, delle belle turbando al riposo.
Welcome back to yet another video on this channel. We want to help you make your video look good. We want to help you make your video look better. We want to help you in your content creation process. And today, it's all going to be about editing faster. Three tips on how to edit your video faster in Final Cut Pro. Let's get it. All right, guys, this video is not going to be long because I really just want to give you guys these three tips and hopefully you guys will find some value in them or maybe just something to start with. I actually have a question at the end because I really want to make a detailed video of each one of these tips. So don't miss that question because it will help me know what content should I create next. So here's the first tip. You have to make or create or develop your own workflow. A workflow is very important because it's your routine. It's how you do things. And I know it can help to see another person's workflow or to learn from another content creator, but the truth is you will have to create your own workflow. It's something that works for you. So let me give you guys an example really quick. And again, I'm not going to go into the details of this yet, but this is what I do. When I finish importing all my clips in Final Cut Pro, and so I start with the first clip immediately and import that on the timeline, on the main storyline, and I cut it, I trim it, I take away what I don't need. And then when I'm done with that first clip, then I move on to the next one. And then when I finish with that, I continue immediately with the music. Yes, I do the music first, and that's what works for me. The music, and then when I'm done with the music, I will add some sound effects if needed. But before that, I actually add some presets, some text presets, some animation presets, and all that stuff that I created. And so that's my initial edit right there. Yeah, but talking about preset, right? That will be my second tip. Create your own preset, use presets, especially something that you use all the time. So I talk about this in one of my video and I'm going to link that right up here. But it's important that you have some presets of the things that you always do and you just, you know, drag them and drop them. The good thing about the video, the kind of video that I'm doing on YouTube is that I'm always in the same area with the same kind of light. I control the lights. Everything is kind of the same. So I created a preset color correcting and color grading for me in this room, in with this setting, with these lights. And every time I edit, when I finish cutting and trimming and putting all the presets and animated presets, text preset and music and sound effects and all of that, I just put an adjustment layer on top of everything on my timeline, and then I put the color correction there, I put the color grading there. I would do the same thing with the audio as well. I'm working with the same mic in the same room all the time when I'm talking like this. And one of those days, probably I'm gonna go out and, you know, have some fun outside, and I will have to deal with the audio differently. But now that I'm using this mic in this room all the time, I just created a preset, the kind of audio that I like with all the settings that I like and the effects that I like. So yeah, I have it as a preset, so I just drag and drop it in my audio and I will be done. Okay, the last tip of today, the third tip of today, is to learn the keyboard shortcut, not key short cut board, board cut. Keyboard shortcuts. I mean, there's a lot of them in there and you can check it out right here in Final Cut Pro preferences, or I think command, and then you will see all this, the shortcuts right there. But you don't need to learn everything. You only need to learn or memorize the keyboard shortcuts that you use the most and you'll be fine. How to trim from the head, or how to trim from the end, and how to cut, how to change volume, how to change speed, how to freeze frame, and, you know, things like that, the things that you use the most for YouTube video. And I'm gonna give you guys an example really quick. These are some of the keys that I usually use, and again, I'm not gonna go into the details yet. That's my question coming up right now, but these are some of the keys. Okay, so if I want to import my clip onto the timeline, I just press W. That's really cool right there. And then if I want to add a clip at the end of the timeline, I would just press E. Or if I want to add a title, or a preset or anything that will go on top of the storyline. These are called connected clips, I believe. And for this, I just press Q and that's it. The footage will go on top of the storyline. If I want to make a cut at a certain point in the clip, I just use these keyboards, Command B, and it will make a cut. And then if I want to trim, then I just use the option bracket, either left or right. Those are some of the really great and really cool shortcuts that I always use. And they're a part of my workflow. And you guys can do the same too. Create your own workflow, use some presets, and then learn some keyboard shortcuts. Okay, so here's the question of the day. Which one of those three tips would you guys wanna see in my next video? Okay, whatever you guys gonna pick out of those three, I'm gonna make a detailed video about that. And hopefully it will be something that will help you in your content creation. All right, guys, that's all I have for this video. If you got any value from it, press that like button. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Push the notification bell so that you will never miss any content like this, just like this one. And I will see you guys in the next video. Hopefully. Peace.